Good morning. Welcome to worship at Trinity Presbyterian Church. My name is Kurt Heinemann. I'm Associate Connections Pastor. Earlier this week, I was spending time with some of the middle school students, and I asked them what their favorite part of Christmas was. All of them at the same time told me it was that moment they wake up on Christmas morning, because they know they get to run downstairs and open up their Christmas presents. And they all told me their least favorite part of Christmas was when mom and dad made them eat breakfast before they had to open their presents. Today is the fourth Sunday of Advent, and we're celebrating joy this morning in worship. And I think that moment in which, if you can remember, if you're a child, you know what I'm talking about, but if you're an adult, if you can remember as a child what it was like to wake up on Christmas morning and you get to go down to that Christmas tree and open up those presents, the mystery of what was inside of those things being unveiled and unfolded and being disclosed to you. That's what we worship today, Jesus Christ coming into the world almost, it's almost Christmas, being born to us a Savior. So with that, will you stand for this morning's call to worship? The call to worship comes from Romans chapter 15, verse 13. It says, "May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, so that you may abound in hope by the power of the Holy Spirit." Being filled up by the Holy Spirit, let's sing joy to the world.
The wonders of God coming, the fullness of God's love and joy in Jesus Christ. It is so great to have you here on this fourth Sunday of Advent. We're going to pass the peace of Christ here in a moment, but before we do, another warm welcome to all of you, especially if you are here for the first time. We would love to know more about you, your information, your prayer requests. This is a detachable card, so we hope that you will fill that out and put it in the offering plate. The Prince of Peace be with you. Let's turn and pass the peace of Christ to those around us.
This way. Okay. Well, you need to hold the candles.
Dart once they're close enough.
Good morning. We're the O'Connor family. This is Mike, James, Leela, and I'm Bernice. Today is the last Sunday of Advent. We light the purple candles to remind us that this is a season of waiting, hope, and peace. Today we light the fourth and final candle, the candle of joy. It reminds us of the joy that comes into the world with the birth of Jesus.
Isaiah 61:11. For as the soil makes the sprout come up, and a garden causes seed to grow, so the sovereign Lord will make righteousness and praise spring up before all nations. Let us pray, O God. We are filled with joy and gladness as we near the celebration of our Savior's birth. We know that your promises are true and that soon the waiting will be over. Come into our hearts and remind us to share the joy of Jesus Christ with everyone around us. Amen.
This is the gospel reading out of Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 25. Here's the story at the center of it all. Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband, Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet, Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus, the gift of God's word. Thanks be to God.
In place of the sermon for today's worship service, we have the Joy Musical. The musical includes the band, the chancel choir, Grace Notes, and Joyful Noise. It's directed by our own Kristen Vervignotis. And for the Joy Musical, there will be a song, and then there will be readings interspersed throughout during the musical today. We hope that in this musical, you will grow closer to that sense of joy that comes only through Jesus Christ and his good news that he brings through God. In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. So Joseph went up from Nazareth to the town of Bethlehem to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling cloths, and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. An angel of the Lord appeared and said, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest."
Thank you. Long before the birth of Christ, the prophet Isaiah foretold that the people who walked in darkness would experience a great light, that they would rejoice before God as people rejoice before the harvest. The world watched and waited.
The promised king did arrive on a starlit night in a stable near Bethlehem. An angel appeared to a group of shepherds and told them they would find the baby wrapped in swaddling cloths, lying in a manger. The shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened."
Oh, The shepherds found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. They fell to their knees and worshiped the newborn king. Then they returned to their flocks, glorifying and praising God for all that they had seen and heard.
Thank you. When Jesus was born king in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he who is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him."
Thank you. Oh,
Wow, and there's going to be more next weekend. So next Saturday night, 5 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 5 o'clock with the kids in costumes here, 8 o'clock with the candlelight service and the Royal Court Brass. So if you're in town, come worship with us. The joy just goes on and on forever. And then we will be worshiping on Christmas Day, and you're free to wear your pajamas. 10 o'clock, okay? So come on out. We'll be here. And the joy goes on all year round. I am so grateful to those who are part of this Trinity family. You help us tell the story, engage in the good news. The way of Jesus endures. All other kingdoms don't. The way of Jesus does. So we give now. We give with our time. We give with our talent. We give with our finances. And we hope that we will end the year strong. We still need about $60,000 to end the year strong. So please give generously to the joyous story. Would the ushers please come forward?
Thank you.
For our praise of the people, I just want to say how amazing it is that we have intergenerational worship here at Trinity. This is uncommon. If you visited a lot of other churches, this is a really unique thing that we do here, that we have children, middle school students, teenagers, adults blended together in a worship service the way that we do here. It's a really incredible thing. So today, what I want to do for the prayers of the people is thank God for each generation and intercede in prayer for them as well. So will you join me in prayers this morning? Let's pray. Lord God, I thank you for the children and the community, for the way their energy, their excitement just brings alive to all of us that joyful sense of what it means to be a human, that there are things that are exciting and worth getting worked up for. So thank you, God, for the children in our community. We pray for them, God, for what it must be like to go to school for the very first time, to be a six-year-old going off to first grade, or to be in preschool, to be in kindergarten. There's a lot of challenges in growing up and becoming a person. And so, Father, I pray for their protection. I pray for their safety, that you would go before them and take care of them. Lord God, I pray for the middle school students, for the teenagers in our community, for that further growth into becoming an adult. And God, that's a special time in life. It can be profoundly challenging. We know that for middle school students, it's hard. For the teenagers, for the high school students in our community, they're taking finals this week before they have Christmas break. And so God, I pray that your spirit would be with them in that time of learning, that you would empower them to be their best selves as they go to those exams this week. Be with them, God. Be with them, we pray, for them, for all the high school students and middle school students right now. Lord, we pray for the young adults in our community. This is not an easy place to live as a young adult. It's hard to access good jobs and work, to pay, to live in a home. So, Father, I pray for all the young adults in the peninsula. This is a hard place to live at times because of the demands of what it costs to live. So, Father, I pray for the young adults. I pray that they would find a sense of joy in their perseverance in this place, and that they would have access to great communities like this, and that they would find deep, meaningful relationships wherever they are, God. Father, I pray for parents in our community of young children and middle school students and teenagers. God, what a gift it is to teach their own children and love them and help them grow up into wonderful people. So God, help this church community love those parents and to love those children. Finally, Father, I pray for the elderly in our community, God, some of whom are at home today that can't be here because they're experiencing medical conditions, because they're having a challenging time getting here. I know some of in our own church have cancer, and they can't be around a large group of people because of what they're going through with their chemo treatments. So, Father, I pray for your spirit to be with them, to bring your healing presence, but also, God, that they could just be lifted up by you and strengthened by your spirit. So, Father, we pray for all of these things, and we give you thanks, God, for this church community that can worship together intergenerationally, and God, that that is a vision of what your kingdom looks like. Your love comes for all of us, and we know that, God, and so we give you thanks this day. And we pray this all in Jesus' name, amen. Just a note before I ask you to stand for the benediction, the poinsettias that are up here on the stage are all dedicated. There's a sheet here, you can look at them. And then next week after worship, if you dedicated them, you can take those poinsettias and bring them home with you after the worship service. All right, will you all stand for this morning's benediction? Go in peace and joy to love and serve the Lord. And may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all now and forevermore. Amen.